guys, Donata here. As promised, I've got a video for you today. We're going to be creating a mini watercolor and soft pastel landscape. I'm going to take you through the materials that I use, the paints, the soft pastel, and the paper. And then we'll flip to desk space and I'll take you through my steps. I do want to add, I don't normally sound like this. I've got some kind of nasally sinusy thing going on, so my voice is a little raspier than usual, but didn't think that should stop us. I also want to apologize if there's any weird noises or some work being done outside, so but I also didn't want that to stop
us. Okay, so I've got you guys.
Anyway, let's get started.
I'm gonna take you through the materials that we're gonna be using today, starting with the watercolor. I like to use Winsor Newton Professional watercolor tubes. The two colors we're going to be using today, I want to sort of keep it simple, are Sepia and Perylene Green. I really like these two colors together. They create a very sort of neutral, a neutral green. So with my color palette chart here, here's my Perylene Green and my Sepia together, and it creates this really nice sort of olive, dark olive green. We're going to use that as the base of our piece, and we're going to lighten the color value of that same color as we work up on the paper. Okay, for the watercolor portion, we're going to be using a large brush. I'm using my Princeton Heritage 16 round because I want the paint to sort of apply itself almost in the form of a wash onto the page. So I'm using one of my larger brushes. You need a jar of clean water and a cloth or some paper towel to remove excess water from your brush or your paper. And then for the paper, I'm using my favorite paper, which is from Feathers and Stone, and it's their cotton rag paper in I think 300 GSM, so it's quite thick. This one is their mini card, so it's 2.5 by about 3.5 inches. And I'm just securing it with a small piece of double-sided tape to the backside so that it doesn't move when I apply my paint and my pastels. Okay, so I've got my two colors on my palette, and I'm just going to create a bit of a pool that is a bit of the Perylene Green and a bit of the Sepia. And when I'm happy with that, I think it needs a little more of the green. I'm gonna remove quite a bit from my brush, but still leaving a lot of the pigment. And I'm gonna start, this kind of goes quickly, watercolor. That's what I sort of love about watercolors. It forces you to work uncomfortably fast, because this paper, given that it's 100% cotton rag, it absorbs very quickly, and I don't want any sort of marks or brush strokes or any lines in my piece. I want it to sort of be very, very gradual. So I'm gonna start by doing the base, and as I go, I'm sort of like, assessing whether I need more or less paint. And I'm working quite quickly, making sure I'm getting all my edges. And then without really needing to clean your brush entirely, I am removing a little excess water. I'm going to start softening that edge and dipping my brush continually in the water as I essentially move the paint up along the page. Just like that. What I love about this brush is that it lifts paint really nicely, and that is due to a combination of the brush but also the paper. So I can go in and I can create lines within my piece again and again. And that just adds a little bit of dimension. So I'm gonna go back in with a bit more paint and add a little bit more pigment, some darker color value, and then soften that up again by going in and removing paint as I go. And that's it, I'm gonna let this dry, and you'll notice as it dries it will change quite a bit. It'll soften and it will, the paint will continue to bleed into itself, creating a very soft, soft dried effect. Okay, so once your piece is fully dried, make sure it's fully dried all the way through. The paper tends to stay a little bit damp for quite a bit of time
on paper that's damp,
so you don't want to be working.
Make sure it's fully dried.
Once we've done that, we can begin to select a color palette. I'm going to be doing this piece just from, I don't have like a photo of any kind of landscape or anything like that. I'm just going to do it from memory and sort of just intuitively. So I want to, I'm kind of wanting to do something with some purples, with this cool green color. So I'm going to select some of these sort of gray violet colors, and then I'm going to lighten that up by using these two. And then I want to complement that purple with a peach color. So I'm going to be using this one, that one. I'm sort of going and looking, referencing back the dark green that I have and generating a palette that I kind of like the way that looks. We'll need some lighter colors for the highlights. And then I'm going to pair. I'm going to pull the same color that I have in the watercolor with my soft pastels, just so that I can create some sort of darker shadowy bits. For the sky, I like to use this very soft pink, and I like to pair it with this really light blue. So that's what we're going to work with. So with my soft pastels, I like to have a damp cloth next to me to clean my hands. It tends to get a little bit out of control, and then I just like to wipe my fingers on a damp cloth to start. So I've arranged my colors sort of the way we've selected them, but I know that these are sort of my sky colors, and then these are going to be my florals, my leaves, grasses, and then pops of purple in between. So the way I like to start is to establish sort of my horizon line. These pastels are Jack Richeson soft pastels. They are very, very soft. They break very easily, but that's what I love about them. They leave a ton of texture behind, and them in combination with the paper, I love the feel and the look of the texture. So I try not to think too much about the quantity of pastel that I'm applying. I like it to be thicker in some bits and softer in others. So I'm just sort of using my kind of intuition here, and I'm placing what would be sort of dark patches of grass sort of along what I think will be a floral field, and I'm just sort of going in very quickly and establishing some of my darker shadow pieces. So once that's done, I'll go in and use this purple, this sort of dark gray immediately. I can sort of see where I want some of the lighter spaces to come out, and when I hold my pastel on a bit of an angle, I create these blotches, if you will, but also these lines that create that sort of appear naturally in the landscape. So I keep going kind of very intuitively, placing some lighter pieces throughout. These would be flowers or bushes, that sort of blend with each other. And I work typically from darker to lighter. Not always, but I feel like it works best with the perspective of a field. And then I want to create sort of a patch of florals here. So I'm actually going to break this piece if I can. Bit of an edge by just removing one of the rounded bits so that I have a line, and then just kind of creating a patch of peachy, orangey flowers, and then I go in and lighten that as I go. And I think I need another color. A softer, lighter orange. I'm going to create there. And then my highlights I'm going to leave for the end because I want them to complement my sky. So for my sky, typically start with my blue. I just want to clean my pastel. Lifting into the left, and then I do like to carry this color through just slightly into the field from the sky. So I'm kind of creating clouds that are sort of moving in this direction, creating these wispy diagonal shapes. So again, I'm going to clean my pink. I'm going to go in and lighten with a clean hand. Some of these I like to go in and blend and merge together. It really depends on the background of the watercolor, just how much I want to do that, but right now it feels like it will work. So again, I want to clean my pastel, and then I'm going in with white, softening, lightening, and creating highlights through the clouds where I would feel, and they're all kind of moving in this direction. So because I'm lightening in this space, I also want to take that highlight. Start whenever that happens, but that's okay. I just take my piece. Actually, these are quite nice because then you can, I don't mind them. Going in and creating some bright space. Reflecting some of it in the florals to kind of bring everything together. And then I like to go in at the end and just sort of find space where a darker sort of shadow just going to, I have some slightly darker pieces that I don't want, so I'm going to lighten those. often. And then go in again with the pink and blue to create my definition in the clouds. There we go. There's the finished piece. See, there's a lot of texture, a lot of depth, and softness with the soft pastel.